Welcome to another episode of Global Banking Finance Review. My name is Deepika Lobo. Today we are going to talk about how having a zero balance affects your credit score. Technically, credit cards are used to borrow funds. The credit card user or the holder uses the card for transactions that require more funds than what he is or currently possesses. These borrowed funds attract a hefty rate of interest if it isn't paid off within a specific time. So credit card users are typically advised to maintain zero balance, that is, to pay off their debt. While leaving credit cards at zero balance might seem like a good idea, it may actually not be the best one in the long run. In fact, studies have shown that credit cards carrying zero balance could have an impact on one's credit score. What's a credit score? A credit score is a standard measure of a person's creditworthiness. It's a number found between the range of 300 to 800 and is used to numerically express one's credit history. Typically, people with high credit scores are much more attractive to lenders, but these people can be expected to pay off their debts. In contrast, low scores indicate the untrustworthiness of the individual to settle outstanding amounts. Thus, financial institutions generally tend to reject loan applications of individuals with low credit scores. Believe it or not, zero balance credit cards affect score to a certain extent. One would think that paying off the card's balance, which is equivalent of settling one's debts, would have a positive impact on one's credit score. However, this is not always the case. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And one lucky winner will win a 1-year free subscription of Global Banking and Finance Review Magazine.